another stranger. You're finally starting to come a little bit aware of what's going on. I was just going over your chart. How are you feeling? Try to make you 100% better as soon as possible. That's our job. But I am happy to see you. Did you enjoy the rest? Before? Okay. Just a few little things. That's okay. Well, we're gonna make sure that everything is okay, and we'll just go through a series of little tests. I'm gonna have a habit of chewing on my pens. Probably not the best habit. But, especially in such a hygienic atmosphere. But don't tell anybody. You won't tell? You're so sweet. Okay. Alright. Do you feel woozy or do you have a headache at this moment? Okay. Have you felt like you've had trouble sleeping? Okay. Is it hard for you to relax any of the parts of your body? Okay. Okay. Just looking at your chart. Between you and me, you're pretty dang impressive. Well, I'm impressed. I'm gonna put your chart to the side so I can take a closer look at you. Okay? Is that alright? Okay. We're gonna do some very simple tests, okay? I just want you to follow the light. Just a basic test. Just see how you're going, how your progress is doing. And you will slowly progress. See if you can keep your attention on my finger right here while I go across you with this light. Yeah, good job. Just follow this light. Okay? Follow this finger. What am I writing down? Oh. Your ability to focus. That's what I'm writing down. What are you focused on at this moment? What is it at this moment? All right, we're just gonna do a little tap here. Okay. You're doing really well. What if I... I'm gonna touch your arm right here, okay? Do you feel this? Okay. How about right here? Okay. Remember whenever I said before the surgery, we're not so sure if you're gonna make a full recovery. Yeah. The problem is that we've never seen a case as severe as yours. Yes. I don't think it's terrible. To have what you have. I think a lot of people might actually really enjoy to have what you have. But I'm sure that the attention that you get must be so overwhelming. All those girls fawning after you. Oh my gosh. let's turn the light on. All right, let's take a nice look. My goodness. I don't know if you really want to know. You know how you came in with the, and the diagnosis was that you're adorable. Yes. Okay, so your diagnosis has not changed. You still have a very acute case of the adorables. Yes. Oh, I know, I'm sorry. There's nothing that we could do to change how adorable you are. Even the surgery. I don't know if you can handle hearing this. I really don't know if you can handle hearing this. I'm really afraid that the surgery might have increased the intensity of how adorable you are. This poses as a little bit of a problem. There's a lot of ways you could deal with this. You could let me take you home and take care of you for the rest of your life. And ignore all the other people trying to attack you because I have your best interest at hand. Absolutely. Yes. With your adorableness. Breathe, 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 breathe. It's okay, I'm okay. You're so thoughtful to worry about me. Especially in the state of how adorable you are. Who, me? Take advantage of you? Oh, never. Never would I take advantage of you. You're just too precious. just too precious. No, won't be okay. I've worked with very acute cases of adorable. I've worked with stage 4 adorable. You might be stage 5, but that's okay. Are you hot, sunshine? Let's fan you off. You look like you need to cool down. A little dizzy. Are you dizzy too? Look at you all taken care of. Breathe. There you go. Take deep breaths. You're gonna be okay. You're more worried about me. Oh. How can you be adorable and thoughtful? That's just too much.